Hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technolobe. And today in this video, we are going to talk about the next iPhone. So we are in that time of the year where the iPhone rumors are really hot and everyone is talking about them. So without wasting any more time, let's get right into my video. Let's get started. Okay. So first of all, let's go ahead and talk about the biggest rumor with the iPhone 8 or the iPhone edition, whatever it may be called, that is the display. So as we all know, in 2017, most of the companies out there are moving towards the bezel-less displays, as we've seen with the LG G6 and the Samsung Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus. Apple is also going to have a bezel-less display on its smartphone, that is the iPhone 8. So it is rumored to have over a 90% screen to body ratio, which is going to be bonkers. So I really love the idea of thin bezels or no bezels at all on your phone, which in turn will make the form factor of the phone small. And as I like small phones, it is a very good thing for me. Now many of the people out there do like small form factors, and that is a very good thing for them because they are going to get bigger displays in small form factors. Now, in some rumors, we've seen that the iPhone has no bezels at all. I don't think that is going to be true because people are saying that the camera, the sensors, and everything is going to be below the screen, but I don't think we are there yet. So as we all know, Apple will incorporate a technology only when it is to its full potential. And I don't think that these sensors going behind the screen is to a full potential yet. So that happening is a very skeptical rumor. But apart from that, over a 90% screen to body ratio, that is happening for sure. Because every other company is doing that, and so is Apple. Now next up, let's talk about that fingerprint sensor. So as we all know, when we have over a 90% screen to body ratio, there is no place for a physical home button. So where will the fingerprint sensor go? Some rumors say that the fingerprint sensor will be embedded into the screen, and some other rumors say that it will be replaced at some other position. Now both of these rumors have some weight to it. Now if Apple can pull off that technology, that is putting the fingerprint sensor into the screen, it is going to be awesome. Everyone is going to go crazy over it, and it is going to be a biggest selling point if they include the fingerprint sensor inside the screen. But some rumors say that it is not possible because the time to produce such devices, that means the time for production increases when you embed the fingerprint sensor into the screen, because you have to add an extra layer to the screen, which in turn will increase the production timing. But on the other hand, Apple can replace the fingerprint sensor, that means it can reposition the fingerprint sensor, and the most likely position is the power button, because in all the rumors, for no reason the power button is elongated, that means this time it is longer. So what could possibly be the reason that the power button is longer? Now we have a shorter power button on the iPhone 7 and we can still reach it. So the only reason for the elongated power button is that Apple is going to introduce a touch sensitive button. That means it will have touch ID, also it will have some gestures like scrolling down, scrolling up or something like that. So that is just my theory, and even Everything Apple Pro, that is Philip from Everything Apple Pro, agrees to this. So if you agree that the fingerprint sensor will be repositioned on the power button, let me know in the comment section down below. Now moving on, let's talk about the build quality. So the build quality on the iPhones always have been premium, but this time as Apple is introducing wireless charging, they cannot have an aluminum body. They have to have a glass back or some other material like ceramic, which can allow wireless charging. But I don't think Apple will go the ceramic route because it is very expensive and very hard to produce. So I guess Apple will go with a glass back and glass front with a stainless steel frame. Yeah, stainless steel. We've all seen this implementation with the Apple Watch, and I think that it is coming to the iPhone because stainless steel and glass are very premium materials, and when they combine together, it gives you a very awesome look, very glossy look, and overall, it maintains the standard, that is the premium quality that Apple has. Now moving on, let's talk about iOS. So iOS 11 is going to be announced in June, that is around June 5th or 6th at WWDC 2017. So iOS this time is going to be a major redesign, because we've seen that iOS has a redesign after every 3 versions, but this time it has already been late. That means the iOS 7 was a redesign, and from there on we haven't seen a complete redesign yet. So I'm hoping that the iOS 11 will have a great redesign, because this year it is the 10th anniversary of the iPhone. It is going to be a flagship device with all those new features. So iOS 11 has to be on point, and it has to be great. It has to be stable, new features, and everything has to be on point. So I'm really excited for iOS 11, and I'll be covering all that is to know about the iOS 11 in June first week. So make a note, you subscribe to the channel for that. So overall, the iPhone 8 or the iPhone edition is going to be awesome. Now alongside with the iPhone 8 or the iPhone edition, Apple is going to launch two new phones, like two more phones you can say, the iPhone 7s and 7s Plus. Those are going to be the standard upgrades, but this one is going to be the flagship because it is the 10th year anniversary. That is, it is the 10th year anniversary of the iPhone, and we are going to see something really special. Now only downside with the iPhone 8 is going to be price. It is not going to be affordable to all. Now already in India we have a lot high prices for the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus, so imagine how costly the iPhone 8 will be. So just start saving now if you want to buy the next iPhone. So anyway, that's been it guys. This was my very quick video about the rumors of the iPhone 8 or the iPhone edition. Do let me know how you feel about this in the comment section down below. If you like this content, go ahead and smash that like button. Also, make a note to subscribe to the channel now. Now about that giveaway. As you all know, a giveaway was going on my channel, that is the Noise Turbo smartwatch. I have already announced the winner on my Instagram. So make a note, you go ahead and check that out and follow me on my Instagram page, because I update each and everything about my channel to my Instagram page. So anyway, that's been it guys. My name is Harsh Punjabi, and I'll see you guys in the next one.